Good day everybody. In this video I would like to talk a little bit about earthquake engineering, and I would like to start with the fundamentals records from earthquakes. The one that you see here is a very common example, and I'm going to use example from my own practice. There was a relatively strong earthquake with magnitude 6.6 in 2007 in the Niigata Prefecture, Japan. We did some investigation afterwards. We look at the damage to natural slope and infrastructure, and I'll talk about it later a little bit. And what we started with was this record of acceleration over time. So this is something that you're gonna get from any earthquake. If you don't have access, I would recommend you to go to the USGS, which is United States Geological Survey website. They always provide records for almost all earthquakes around the world, so this is where you can find it. So also you can get in other records, like shown here, these two plots. The way that I did, I use software which is called Microshake, and that software did analysis of acceleration versus time record to obtain velocity over time and displacement over time. So this is actually provide you with very important information. You can look at the maximum displacement, so gonna be here, and this is what we called peak ground displacement. So you see, in this case, it was about 40 centimeters. If you think about it, it's actually a pretty large displacement that can lead to, let's say, problems on natural slopes, like the one you see here. This is landslide. So this is very common type of earthquake-triggered landslides. It's shallow. It's about 1 to 2 meters. And it also happens on relatively steep slopes, something about 45, 50 degrees in the weathered bedrock. So this was mudstone. So this was weathered mudstone. Another damage that we observed was in the port area. So you see there is a river here. So usually here we would see lots of liquefaction, and that's actually what we see here. If you've watched my other videos, you should probably know that this is called sand boils. So this is sand that came to the surface from the underground due to very high water pressure. This is the damage to the pavement, the tiles. You see there was some displacement. Lots of change in displacement in the horizontal and the vertical direction. So this actually costs lots of money to fix. So what we're going to get, let's go back to this chart. What we're going to get from this chart and what we typically need to have is peak ground acceleration. So let's call it PGA. And we just estimated from the chart, I would say it's about 0.38 g's. Why do we need that? If you haven't seen my video how to estimate the liquefaction potential of sand, please watch that one. I'll probably put a link to that video in the description. So you will see this is very important information that we need to know. So once we know the typical type of earthquake in that area, we can do design, we can do slope stability analysis, we can calculate seismic coefficient for slope stability analysis, we can also estimate the liquefaction potential, and for that one we need this value, PGA. We can also get peak ground velocity from here, and here peak ground displacement. It will give us a little bit of more information, but most of the time we need to get this PGA, right? And let's do, in the end of this video, let's do a short exercise. Let's see how we can actually use this data. For example, let's say that this record was from the epicenter, and from the epicenter we know that peak ground acceleration was 0.38 g's. So now what we can do, we can estimate what was the peak ground acceleration, for example, 50 kilometers away from the epicenter. The way to do it, we just look at these empirical plots and get some relatively accurate estimations. So you see that these are plots provided by this researcher, Boer. So it's for magnitude of 6 and magnitude of 7.5. So let's say that that earthquake has 6.6 magnitude. So let's just go with this one, right? Anyway, it's still estimation. Well, it's not very accurate, but we'll try to make it as accurate as possible. And we know that peak ground acceleration was 0.38, so 0.38 somewhere here. So we need to follow this trend, and we're gonna get some, I said 50 kilometers away, right? So that will be 20, 30, 40, 50. So I believe it should be somewhere here. Somewhere here, right? So 50 kilometers away from the epicenter, the PGA will be around, let's see, 0.12 Gs, right? So that's how we use this chart. So that we can have a better idea of what happened around the epicenter. That's it for this video. I'm gonna make a few more videos about earthquake engineering. Have a nice day and bye.